So you think you know debits and credits. Let's put your knowledge to the test. I'm James, and today I've got 20 multiple choice questions lined up for you. We'll start simple, but things will get trickier as we go. That's a guarantee. So play along, keep a track of your score, and don't forget to share it in the comments at the end. Question 1. In double entry accounting, every transaction affects two or more accounts, affects only one account, is recorded only when cash changes hands, or can be recorded without balancing debits and credits. The answer is A. In double entry accounting, there are two equal and opposite sides to every transaction. This ensures that the accounting equation is kept in balance. Question 2. Debits and credits are best described as good and bad, the same as adding and subtracting, words showing the duality of transactions, or random labels with no meaning. It's C. Debits and credits are words used to reflect the double-sided nature of financial transactions. Every entry has to balance, which means total debits have to equal total credits. Question 3. Debits are recorded on which side of the ledger? The top, the bottom, the left, or the right? The answer is C. Debits are always recorded on the left side of a T account. This format is used worldwide to avoid confusion. Question 4. Which side of a ledger are credits recorded on? The top, the bottom, the left, or the right? The answer is of course D. Debits go on the left and credits go on the right. Question 5. A debit increases the balance of which type of account? Assets, liabilities, equity, or revenue? And the answer is A. Assets are represented by the A in dealer. This means they're normal debit accounts. So debits increase them and credits decrease them. Question 6. A credit increases which type of account? Assets, dividends, expenses, or liabilities? It's D. Liabilities are represented by the L in dealer. This means they're normal credit accounts. So credits increase liabilities and debits decrease them. If you're finding this tough and want a quick way to review the basics, check out my all-in-one accounting cheat sheet bundle. The second edition is fully updated in color and packed with everything you need to learn accounting faster. You can grab it at accountingstuff.com/shop or follow the link in the description. Right, time for some quick ones. Do you debit or credit a cash account to increase it? The answer is A. Cash is of course a type of asset, so it's a normal debit account. So you debit a cash account to increase it. Question 8. Do you debit or credit cost of sales to decrease it? And it's B. Cost of sales is a type of expense represented by the first E in dealer, so it's a normal debit account. This means you credit cost of sales to decrease it. Question 9. Do you debit or credit sales revenue to increase it? B again. Sales revenue is a type of revenue. It's represented by the R in dealer, so it's a normal credit account. This means you credit sales revenue to increase it. Question 10. Do debit or credit retained earnings to increase it? B. Retained earnings is a form of equity represented by the second E in dealer. So it's a normal credit account and credits increase it. Question 11. Do debit or credit dividends to decrease it? And again, it's B. Dividends is the D in dealer, so it's a normal debit account. That means credits decrease dividends. Question 12. Do debit or credit accrued expenses to decrease it? It's A. Accrued expenses is an adjusting entry account that you need to watch out for. It's a type of liability, so it's a normal credit account. That means you would debit accrued expenses to decrease it. Now that we've covered the foundations, let's work with some scenarios. Question 13. A business provides services to a client on credit. Which account should they debit? Is it cash, unearned revenue, service revenue, or accounts receivable? The answer is D. When services are provided on credit, the client owes the business money. So accounts receivable, which is an asset, is debited to record the amount due. The other side of the transaction is a credit to service revenue to recognize the income earned. Question 14. A business pays a supplier for inventory that was originally purchased on account. Which account is credited? Is it accounts payable, cash, inventory, or revenue? It's B. When the business pays its supplier, cash, an asset, is credited to reflect the outflow of money. The other side of the entry is a debit to accounts payable, which reduces the liability owed to the supplier. Question 15. A business records depreciation on its equipment. Which account should they credit? Equipment, accumulated depreciation expenses, or cash? It's B. Depreciation reduces the book value of equipment over time. But instead of crediting the asset directly, we credit accumulated depreciation. This is a contra asset account which runs against the flow of fixed assets on the balance sheet. The other side of this transaction is a debit to depreciation expenses, which records the cost on the income statement. Question 16. A business writes off an uncollectible amount that wasn't provided for. Which account is debited? Accounts receivable, cash, the allowance for doubtful debts, or the bad debt expense account? The answer is D. If the bad debt hasn't been provided for, then the business should debit the bad debt expense account to record the cost on the income statement. The other side of the entry is a credit to accounts receivable, which reduces assets on the balance sheet. Question 17. A business provides services to a client but hasn't billed them by the end of the month. Which account should they debit? Is it cash, service revenue, accrued revenue, or unearned revenue? It's C. The business should debit accrued revenue to increase assets on the balance sheet. This reflects the unbilled revenue owed to them by the client. The credit entry is to service revenue to record the income earned on the income statement. Question 18. A business uses electricity but hasn't received the bill by the end of the month. Which account should they credit? accrued expenses, utility expenses, cash, or prepaid expenses. The answer is A. They haven't received a bill, so they should credit accrued expenses to increase liabilities on the balance sheet. This reflects the amount that they expect to owe. The other side should be a debit to utility expenses to record the cost on the income statement. Question 19. When closing a revenue account at the end of an accounting period, which account is credited? Is it revenue, the income summary account, accounts payable, or cash? The answer is B. When posting closing entries, we debit revenue accounts to clear them down to zero. Their balances are transferred to the income summary account, which is credited to increase it. This account is then closed to retained earnings. Question 20. A business sells inventory for $500 cash. It originally cost $300. Which accounts are debited? Cash by $500 and inventory by $300. Cash by $500 and revenue by $300, cash by $500 and cost of goods sold by $300, or cash by $500 and inventory by $300. The answer is C. We debit cash by the sale amount of $500 to increase assets on the balance sheet. We also debit cost of goods sold by the book value of the inventory of $300 to record the cost on the income statement. On the flip side, we credit revenue by $500 and inventory by $300. Bonus question. The main purpose of which report is to check that total debits equal total credits? Is it the balance sheet, the trial balance, the income statement, or the cash flow statement? The answer is B. The trial balance shows the balances of all accounts in the general ledger at a point in time. It helps us check the total debits equal total credits. How did you go? Don't forget to share your score in the comments below. If you'd like a copy of my debit and credit cheat sheet, the link is right here. And if you want to keep on learning, why not give this video a watch next? All the best, and don't forget to subscribe for more accounting quizzes and tutorials.